How you doing, people? We're gonna take a quick look at Top Gun Maverick. This is, of course, the sequel to the 1986 movie Top Gun, directed by Joseph Kosinski and starring Tom Cruise, Jennifer Connelly, and Miles Teller. About 30 years after the events of Top Gun, Pete Maverick Mitchell now makes a living as a test pilot. But he's called back into action as his old friend Iceman, who is now an admiral, wants him to rejoin Top Gun as an instructor. His job is to train a new batch of recruits to perform an extremely difficult mission. One might say it's an impossible mission. Wait, no, that's a different Tom Cruise franchise, I'm sorry. In addition to watching Maverick, I also rewatched the original Top Gun, which, honestly, I always thought was a bit overrated. Not bad. Overrated does not mean bad, I just don't think it was as good as a lot of people seem to give it credit for. This might be because I didn't see it when it first came out. The first time I watched it, I think, was almost 20 years after the fact. Had I seen it in 1986, well, in 1986 I was 5, so probably the only thing I'd remember would be all the planes flying around. It is very much a product of the 1980s. Of course, all of the aerial cinematography and the combat sequences were groundbreaking at the time and still hold up pretty well. But that's about all that holds up. It's very thin on plot and stakes until about the last 20 minutes or so. And Maverick is kind of a jackass. In fact, pretty much every Top Gun recruit in this movie is a jackass, except maybe Goose. And of course, he is the one that dies. Oh, sorry, spoilers. Also, and oh, I'm gonna regret saying this in public. I think Take My Breath Away is overrated. I'm sorry. It's not, again, overrated does not mean bad. It's not bad. It's just, I didn't think it was that good. I certainly didn't think it was worthy of an Oscar. Obviously, the Academy disagreed, but yeah, there. Take My Breath Away is overrated. There, I said it. Now that we have that out of the way, and at least half of you have stopped watching, the sequel has been in development for a long time. Took about a decade for it to finally hit theaters, which is not always a good sign. In this case, it was largely delayed because Tony Scott was supposed to come back to direct this one, but sadly, he committed suicide before they started production, and everything, understandably, ground to a halt at that point. Eventually, they did get it made with Kosinski in the chair. This is the same guy who directed Oblivion and Tron Legacy, neither of which were exactly great movies, in my opinion, but that's not really the fault of the director. That was more the script. So, yeah, I mean, both movies were shot well enough, so Kosinski was not necessarily a bad choice. And now that Top Gun Maverick has finally hit theaters, I can honestly say this was worth the wait. Oh my god, this was really good. It still has what I enjoyed about the original, and it improves on a lot of its weaknesses. Really, I think this is what the original Top Gun should have been. Maverick is not the jackass he used to be. He has grown and matured since then. Much better human being, but certainly still a flawed human being. He's not perfect by any means. He seems to have a problem knowing when to quit, as evidenced by the test pilot sequence at the beginning of the movie, where he pushes the plane just a little too hard, because apparently he's still got the need. The need for speed. Had to work that in somewhere. Cruise is, surprise, still a good actor, and adapts to this older and arguably wiser version of Maverick very well. I do love how he still says, "Talk to me, Goose," while he's in the plane. That's a nice touch. Really, there's just one guy that is a jackass, and that's a pilot known as Hangman, played by Glenn Powell. But the movie makes it very clear that he is indeed a jackass. You are not supposed to like this guy, and his behavior is not rewarded. Miles Teller does a very good job as Rooster, the son of Goose, who is one of the recruits at Top Gun that Tom Cruise has to teach. Definitely has a chip on his shoulder, and obviously not without reason. He has been through a lot, and he and Maverick do not get along, at least at first, because he still blames Maverick for Goose's death. And there are some other reasons as well that I won't get into because spoilers. And it is amazing how much he looks like Goose's son. I mean, they did a great job there. Connelly plays Penny, an old flame of Maverick's that he apparently had a thing with sometime in the past 30 years. Looks amazing, by the way. And she and Cruise had pretty good chemistry overall. And there was one very funny moment with them when she takes him home because she thinks her daughter is sleeping over at a friend's house and they're going to have the house to themselves. But she comes home early, unexpectedly, and Maverick actually has to sneak out of the window. And I'm watching this like, what are you people doing? You're grown-ass adults and you're acting like teenagers who have to sneak out of the house because the parents just came home. What is going on here? And I'm very happy they found a way to work Val Kilmer into the movie. He only has one scene. It's just him and Cruz. Doesn't have many lines because since his battle with cancer, he can't speak very well. But it was a very touching moment. Unlike the first movie, we have actual stakes right from the get-go. Maverick is not just teaching these guys to be great pilots, he's teaching them for a very specific mission, which is they have to take out some sort of base out in some country, which they never actually say where it is. And of course, all the enemy pilots have these, you know, hoods over their faces, so you can't even tell what they look like. But they are apparently doing some illegal uranium enrichment with the intention of making nuclear weapons, and they have to take out the facility, basically by doing a real-life version of the Death Star run. And it was kind of cool to see what a real-world equivalent of the Death Star run might look like. And it actually seemed plausible. I don't know how plausible it would be. I'm sure there's some movie magic in there somewhere, but it looked really cool. And as I said, the aerial cinematography and the action sequences are what the original Top Gun was known for, and this movie definitely lived up to that. The training scenes, the Death Star run, the dog fighting, it all looks fantastic and is a lot of fun to watch. And credit has to go to the actors in those scenes as well, because they do a lot of practical effects in this movie, and they are actually in those jets. And when they are, they basically have to direct themselves, because obviously you don't have the crew standing on the wing going, okay, cut! But like, they have to operate their own cameras and everything. Like, they really had to put in the work, and it shows. One thing that is missing from this movie is the homoerotic beach volleyball scene, which I'm sure will disappoint many people. There is a scene of them playing football on the beach, which it's just not the same. And there's no playing with the boys in the soundtrack. Although, I don't think it would fit if there was, because they do actually have a female recruit this time, so yeah. Playing with the people, nah, doesn't work. Not gay enough. Overall, I thought this movie was excellent. I definitely thought it was better than the original, and I highly recommend checking it out. Up to you whether you want to see it in a theater or wait for home viewing, but one way or another, you definitely should see it. It's great. And that's all I gotta say about Top Gun Maverick. Till next time, take care.